In this illustration, we'll discuss about a bullet penetrating a plank. The situation is stated as having gone through a plank of thickness h. A bullet velocity changes from v0 to v. And here we are required to find the time of motion of bullet in plank if inside plank the resistance force is proportional to square of velocity. So here we can write as resistance force is proportional to square of velocity, we can write inside plank acceleration of bullet can be taken as acceleration, we can write as minus kv square, as resistance force is proportional to square of velocity. So acceleration will also be proportional to square of velocity as bullet mass is not changing during motion. So in this situation, we can write this acceleration as vdv by dx is equals to minus kv square. Here one v gets cancelled out. And this can be written as dv over v is equals to minus k dx. If we integrate these terms with x equals to 0, the velocity of bullet was v0, and after traveling a distance h in the plank, its velocity reduces to v. So on left hand side, this will become ln of v with limits from v0 to v, and on right hand side, it is minus k h. So this will be ln of v minus ln v0. This will be ln of v by v0 is minus k by h, which will give us the value of the proportionality constant we have introduced in the beginning, which is equals to 1 by h. And this negative sign we can use in reversing the sign of this ratio. So this is 1 by h ln of v0 by v. Now further, if we continue, we are required to find the time of motion of bullet. So we can write A as dv by dt, which is again minus kv square. And here we can write it as dv by v square is minus k dt. And if we further integrate this with t equals to 0, speed was v0, and at time t, speed changes to v. Then on integrating this, it will give us minus 1 by v with limits we can put as v0 to v as minus kt. So in this situation, we substitute the limits. This will give us 1 by v0 minus 1 by v is equals to minus of kt. The value of k we can write as 1 by h ln of, again with minus sign, we can use it as v by v0. Multiplied by t. So in this expression, we further solve it. The value of time we are getting here as h multiplied by v0 minus v divided by vv0 ln of v0 by v. Here again we have reversed the ratio as it should be a positive value. And the value of v will certainly be less than v0. So this will be the final result of this problem.